I've forgotten my subject. But here we go. I forgot what annoyed me, or disgusted me, or disturbed me. That I wanted to cover. Maybe it'll come to mind. Get after it, motherfuckers. You gotta whisper, cause the micro. Checking out the metal series on DC. Nth Metal, I believe it's the subject that make up some of these items, like the I think one of the first weapons that killed, I forget Hawkman, I forget his character name, but Hawkman, which put him in him and his lover, or his wife, his soulmate, in a state of reincarnation with every death. Sirens in the distance. You know, I lived in places, in other cities and towns where what you're hearing is a helicopter. Probably a police helicopter, or a sheriff's helicopter. And before that, the lovely sounds of sirens. I can't tell if they were ambulance, or fire truck, or police. But I noticed that while I'm asleep in a small town that I wasn't counting sirens instead of sheep. You know, and that thought does come to mind. Scumbags. Will the scumbag ever go extinct? I don't think so, man. And from one perspective, that could be depressing or sad. Another point of view could be awesome, because it gives people a chance to do the right thing, to stand up and fight. I think that's why the World War II generation was called the greatest generation. I need to listen to that clip again of George Carlin of I'm trying to think if he called the world a circus or a sideshow, that he now roots for a catastrophe. Who is it? Better have some pizza or some fucking pussy. And I forget how the thought came to be where the structure of society of America, of our culture, of neighborhoods, the idea of family. First, I'll mention how I find comfort in this questioning of it, because I don't have kids, no offspring. I don't want any either. So I think it would add a whole different amount of pressure on me. I recollect how I grew up, what I was exposed to, and even more pathetic, what I was not exposed to. Learning about unity, teamwork, going through this, man. Honor, courage, and commitment. Instead of greed, accumulation, having things, looking cool, ego. Taking selfies instead of serving your country.
Combination of words I could put on the back of a postcard. No song that I could sing, but I would drive your heart. Our dreams, and they are made out of real things, like a shoebox of photographs with sepia tone loving. Love is the answer, release for most of the questions.
You know, what is the square footage? What's the word? Acreage? For people to live together peacefully, united, comfortably, so lovingly, effectively. Because if they mention all those fucking sirens, helicopters, traffic, guard dogs, niggers, spics, race baiting, crime. Unsolved crime, unreported crime, bad luck, good luck, bitter people, effective people, loving people, hateful people. They're all there. And I do think you weaken yourself if you remember this one dumb cunt, I said, you know, why don't you get on that, Ferris wheel, or whatever, that local, roller coaster, from these carnies that, come in and set up and, do their amusement rides. I said, I don't know, you know, what if it breaks down and crashes and breaks, I don't know. And I said that in a sort of half tone of seriousness and playfulness, and hey, I don't know these motherfuckers. I remember this dumb Christian or Catholic bitch was like, no, that would never happen here. Totally never happen here. Who's being naive and stupid here, man? And I remember being a kid saying this. But even I thought of the probability of a bad possibility. You know, in theory, I should be able to walk down any sidewalk in the United States at 3 a.m. by myself. In theory. That isn't. It's not logical. It's not safe to do that. And some people could say, you know, you're just thinking bad, being jaded, pessimistic. And no, I think people are people, man. And I keep at this right here because if I could sell more, share more, increase sales, I think more profits and more pussy will come along my way. And I wouldn't mind that. I know I could just knock on the bat by bad luck. I could just knock on a bad door, turn down the wrong street. Go to a store at the wrong time or the right time. Or how about this, the unfortunate time, and have a bad day. Such is life, motherfuckers. All I can do now is just fatten up my piggy bank. Make it strong enough to get off of life support. No longer needing a defibrillator, if that's how you pronounce it. Blink twice if you're okay. Get after it, motherfuckers.